Here.
Hi, everybody. Thank you for joining us.
It's so nice to see you. I thought it might be good to tell them a little bit about what we did this weekend.
Okay.
Let's see.
What did we do?
There was a sunny day.
I went for a bike ride, my first good long bike ride of the year, and it was really fun.
That must have felt really good. I got to go for a walk this weekend. I stayed home a lot because I was making bread. And so I was just waiting for it to rise for hours and hours, which is something I love to do. And it's a good thing to do if you have a lot of time at home.
That's true. You weren't just waiting. You were keeping pretty busy.
That's true. Another thing we did this weekend is we started to make some masks.
We were sewing. Which we enjoy doing.
Yeah, I love to sew. I love to be helpful if I can. And yes. So I was really enjoying making these masks.
Why don't we show our friends what we made? Well, really, Erin, you made these. What do you show?
So I made these masks for us to wear, and I did feel very proud of them. That's true.
They're great, and they're kind of pretty.
Yeah, but
I enjoyed sewing.
I did enjoy sewing them, but as I was making them, then I also started to think, gosh, we are making masks to wear every time we go outside, and that is a very strange feeling. It's a little bit of a worried feeling, and also kind of an angry feeling or a frustrated feeling. It just actually gave me a lot of feelings, and I'm not sure I could even name all of them.
Yeah, it was a lot, and we know that we're going to be wearing them when we go out now.
Yeah, and it's important to be safe.
It's important to be safe. It's important that we put them on so that we don't share any germs with anybody.
Right.
And they don't share any germs with us.
Yeah. Right?
And that's something kids can do too when they go out. Not if they're just out in their yard or out for a walk, but if they went into a store, which they probably won't be doing for a little while, we put on our masks because all the doctors and nurses are so busy.
Right.
They're making sure they take care of people who really are sick. And so we take extra good care of ourselves, make sure that we don't get sick and nobody else around us gets sick. So that's mine. Should we put them on and show everybody what our masks look like?
It helps me always to remember that it's about keeping us safe and also about taking care of other people. And that actually is a really good feeling.
Well, you like to be helpful.
I do like to be
helpful. If you wear your mask, you can be helpful. Let's see. Yeah. Can you tell that I'm smiling at you?
I can from your eyes, actually.
When I see people, I always like to smile at them.
Mm-hmm.
And when I see my friends at school, I really do like to smile at them. And I'm worried they might not know I'm smiling, but I really am. I'm smiling right at you, and I'm smiling at you because I care about you. And I'm happy to see everybody.
You know what I started doing is just saying a really, really friendly hello.
Yes.
Even through my mask. Just a hello! Hi! So that people will know that I am smiling.
Yes. Well, let's take these off.
Mm-hmm.
So, but we'll keep them handy because we will be using them.
Yeah, to be safe.
So, what did you do with all those feelings? Kind of a blue.
Sometimes it's hard to know what to do. I know that since I stopped being able to go to my school, I have had some blue days. It makes me sad not to be able to go there.
Yeah. You're not sick.
Right.
Right? And it's hard to understand, but it's just something everybody's doing to be extra, extra safe and careful to take care of ourselves and the people we love and our neighbors and people we don't even know.
It's true. Well, when I was having some of those blue feelings, I actually picked up this book and I started looking through it because I remembered that you got this book for us when we were little kids. for some of our blue days, because blue days didn't start just now.
That's true. That's true.
And we adapted this book a little bit.
We did. We changed the words a little bit, but we want to share it with all of you.
Are you ready? This is the Blue Day book.
And don't you worry, we're going to show you the pictures.
Well, that's really my favorite thing about this book, is all of the pictures.
So, this is adapted from the Blue Day book by Bradley Trevor Grieve.
Everybody has blue days.
These are miserable days when you feel lousy,
grumpy,
lonely,
and utterly exhausted. Days when you feel small and insignificant, like nobody even notices you.
When everything seems out of reach.
Just getting started seems impossible.
On blue days, it can feel like everybody's out to get you.
You feel frustrated, worried, and anxious.
Do you ever feel like you might just burst into tears and you don't even know why?
Yes, I sometimes feel that way. Sometimes it doesn't take very much to bring on a blue day.
You might just wake up not feeling or even looking your best.
You might make a mistake or get embarrassed.
Someone might call you a name that hurts your feelings.
It might just be a plain old bad hair day.
I am having one of those.
You are not. I disagree.
Maybe it feels like someone's picking on you.
Maybe everyone in your house is driving you crazy.
Not this house.
Not this house.
You might have a headache.
Or a tummy ache.
Or just feel all twisted up inside. What to do? What to do?
Whatever the reason, it's a blue, blue day.
You don't have to run away and hide, although sometimes you might just want to be alone.
Who knows what fantastic things are just around the corner?
After all, the world is full of amazing discoveries.
Things you can't even imagine now.
There are delicious and happy sniffs and smells.
And scrumptious snacks to share.
You might even find a fabulous treasure.
Or become a superstar one day.
That sounds pretty good, doesn't it?
It does. But wait, there's more!
There are handstands.
And games to play.
And yoga.
And singing karaoke.
And wild and silly dancing.
And there's love.
And cuddles.
And smooches.
So how can we get that peaceful, calm feeling?
It is not always easy, but there are some things you can try.
Okay, you can sit and take some deep breaths in through your nose, out through your mouth. Try closing your eyes and counting to 10.
Take a walk around the room or around the neighborhood.
Try seeing things from a different perspective.
If someone is doing something wrong, you can stand up tall and say, "That is not right and it's not okay with me." Don't be afraid to use your powerful voice.
And if you notice that you made a mistake, be brave and say you're sorry.
Sometimes that's really hard.
It is hard.
Be proud of who you are.
And laugh at yourself when you do something silly.
Talk to people who make you smile. Even if it's on the phone.
Sure. Take risks.
Don't hang back. Go for it. When you see something that makes you smile, kick up your feet and jump for joy.
Then take a deep breath and notice if you feel just a little bit better.
I actually do.
I do like that book very much.
I like that one too. Well, last week I definitely did have a blue day. And I told you that. And you actually played me this song.
Well, I played it for you because I love this song. It's an old song. And it's by the Kinks, and it's called Better Things. And sometimes that song is just the thing I need to get me up and out of bed and do what needs to be done.
I hear that. I have those songs too. When I heard this one, you know what it actually made me think of?
What?
It made me think of when we get to go on the video with our classes, and we get to see all the students. And especially it made me think of when we sing a song and we can see that they are just dancing and rocking out and having a good time.
It makes me really happy. I love seeing that.
It makes me really happy too.
I think we should play the song for the kids.
I think we should too. We should tell them though. Well, we've been trying a lot of new things lately because
we have
time and there's some things we want to do and try.
Yeah. Well, and some of our first choice things aren't always available. My favorite granola, we didn't have in the house. And we don't want to be running out to the grocery store a lot. Because that's not the safest thing to do. So I had to come up with a second choice. Also, we wanted to add some piano to our song.
We did. But
here's the thing.
We don't have a piano.
We don't play the piano.
You can see our conundrum.
So here's what we did. I'll just, should I show them the keyboard?
You should show them. You were so creative about this.
So, I did get a little keyboard on my iPad. And we played around with it. And we kind of figured out how to play the piano part that we wanted to add to the song.
We did.
In a way that makes us happy.
Right. And we have been practicing a lot because we have some time. But it might not be perfect. But, you know. We brush it off because we're here having fun.
Brush it off.
So, are you ready? Should we play the song?
Let's do it. I think our friends will understand.
Okay, let's go.
Are you ready?
I think so.
Okay.
Like you've just begun.